The cricket was killed the other day by a bullfrog in a parking lot on East West Street.
Say it, yes,
product is Ask Xandar a better product than this Magic 8 Ball? My reply is hazy. Try again. Okay. Is Ask Xandar better than you? Very doubtful.
Yeah!
So I should get you instead of Ask Xandar? Concentrate and ask again.
Yeah!
Should I get you instead of Xandar the next time?
Yeah!
It is decidedly so.
Hey, it's out of focus.
Ask Xandar sucks.
Does Ask Xandar suck? My outlook is not good.
Is Ask Xandar crap?
Is Ask Xandar a piece of crap? Come on, come on, come on, come on. Idiot. Outlook is good. So these don't really work. They just fly down to the ground. Never works. Isn't you can see a little red dot right there somewhere. See that? It's in the reflection of the glass. Whatever it is. Have you ever noticed how TVs have this nasty static noise when you turn it on channel 3 or 2, you don't have HBO? And if you do have HBO, why the heck are you watching this?
Good question.
Stop that. You're following Justin, your short story was terrible. Keep it up. Let's work on this beginnings on the begin in the beginning sometime. No wait. Let's go out to Hardee's sometime. Yeah, that's what it says. Sorry. Out of quarter. 27:49. Call Aunt Faye. out of the R is backwards on here, Justin.
I never noticed that.
Ian says that he has one of these and you can't use it because one of them are crooked.
Yeah, he told
me. My little sister has one of these. I tried to kill it, but it didn't work. Have you ever noticed how you can't tip too back far on rocking chairs or else you'll fall over?
No.
No. Then you're stupid.
No.
I'm afraid so, Bobby.
You're stupid, Neil.
I know you guys. Let's go sledding.
Fun. Let's do it again. I have a live interview of Neil Pohl.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay. That's my magnifying glass.
Yeah? Go down and get it.
Something's wrong.
Well, the other day I went to the
store?
Yes, that's it, the store. And I went
shopping.
Yes, that's it, I went shopping. And this lady asked me, are you gonna buy those
shoes? Jerk.
Yeah, jerk.
Whoops.
And, well, how did you know all that?
Because you've told me that story every month for the past 20 years.
Oh.
Hello, everybody, and we're here with an interview with
Bobby Lucy.
Hi. And, so, as a sixth grader, how do you like to have a seventh grade show? What do you mean? I mean, like, how do you like to be on a seventh grade show with seventh graders in it?
I don't care.
Do you think you're funny?
No. Not all the time.
Do other people think you're funny?
Sometimes.
And Okay. So, what does your daily life include?
School, playing the computer. Sorry.
What's that?
What the heck is that?
Nothing. Going to school, playing the computer, doing homework, stuff like that.
You lead a very complicated and fun life.
I eat, I sleep, I drink, I walk, I look at the tiles on the ceiling.
Well, that makes a difference.
See, look at all those neat lights up there. Aren't they
yeah,
right?
They're neat lights.
And there's that cool TV. And stuff. The overheads are blue.
Do you ever wish you had a home entertainment center in your room?
Oh, yeah. But a computer's sufficient.
Okay, you have a computer in your room?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, I can give you an entertainment center in your room.
Get out of here.
Who's that?
Excuse me for a minute.
Sure.
Just keep it rolling.
Uh-oh.
Hey, yeah.
Okay. Hi. I'm the cameraman.
Go away.
Yes, he is. Now,
what's that?
It is something.
Phone
something.
Projector.
It is. It's something that you could use for your home entertainment center at your house. If you just got a whole bunch of these, you'd have your very own home entertainment center. Mr. H will give these away for free.
Woo-hoo.
Okay, $5. But otherwise, it's pretty much free, and you just get a whole bunch of them. You set them up there. You got your own little entertainment center, which you can watch little reels of film if you can find any at the library. If they are even, they're so old-fashioned sometimes that, well, on with the interview. Crossing guard, sixth grade b-ball, community pot luck. Change about Toki. Mr. Edmonds Blues guy. Roll tape Uncle Rob. Okay. Well, this is stuff from... If any of you go to Akira Toki Middle School, you will know that we have a show called Toki Talk. This is the script for last week. Well, do you have anything to say to the audience?
You all suck.
No, nice to the audience.
Oh. You all sort of suck.
And by the way, you're supposed to hold your mouth at least 4 inches at the most.
Why? Isn't this thing very sensitive?
It's too sensitive.
Well, why 4 inches?
It's too sensitive. 4 inches because it's just good enough. Hey. Okay. Hey, does Neil, the cameraman, want to join the interview? Oh no! We're all getting sucked away!
Hi, my name is Bobby Luthi.
Ow!
Kill it!
I'm very patriotic. This was all my plan to take over Justin's show.
Yes, please do.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I am Snob Edified. Welcome to a brand new season of Reese's Peace Theater on WJMR. If you are just joining us on this brand new season of things. In this theater, we roll clips backwards from earlier in the show Express Yourself Backwards. Now, for those of you who stay in touch with my showbiz career, you might have noticed that I have just done another show previously, Home Sweet Home. And why am I not doing it now? I still am. But just am doing both for twice the salary. I found out they gave me a raise last time I quitted. Reese's Peace Theater, and so I decided to stay. Well, here is a very interesting clip rolled backwards from earlier in Express Yourself. It was when Justin Riley, the star, director, camera person, producer, creator, just about everything, went down the hill in his sled, and then Neil Pohl came and crashed into him. We're going to roll that backwards now. Let's take a look. Well, that one was pretty funny. But as a little added clip, additional effects for our show, we decided to put it into slow motion and not just backwards motion. Here is that very same clip in forward motion, only slow down a little bit. Let's take a look. And there you have it. A wonderful one clip made into two special funny effects. Well, I guess for now this ends our session for the new season of Reese's Peace Theater. I'm Snobby Refined, your host, reminding you to watch Home Sweet Home whenever you can. Good night.
Has this ever happened to you?
Give me your lunch money, creep!
Stop! Now what do you do? Do you give him the money?
Give it to me! Right now!
Okay!
Very good.
Okay. Oh! Or do you do this?
Oh, give me your lunch money, creep!
No!
Hey, come back here!
Or are you one of those poor, unfortunate souls who does this?
Oh, give me your lunch money, creep!
And of course, there's always that teacher who has it out for you, the victim.
They got right on the other side.
How dare you pick on poor defenseless lunch money stealers? You are coming with me.
Excuse me, sir. You're gonna have to come with me.
Who are you, anyway?
I'm Sam Bubbles from H&R Cube. We're not just a tax thingy anymore.
Why am I here?
I'm afraid you've been a victim of a VMT.
What's a VMT?
A very mean teacher. You, got money?
Well, that bully guy stole it.
Where's the bully now?
Well, the bully runs free now.
Well, Screw him. Come with me, son. I know a great carpenter. I'd like to call Bobby Luthy to the stand. So you claim that the trash can ate you?
Well, no.
Up. No further questions. I'd like to call the trash can to the stand. So, did you eat Bobby Luthy?
Well, no, actually, I was fed.
What were you fed with?
I was fed with a poor, innocent kid who was, had his lunch money taken.
I find it hard to believe that a trash can talks by itself.
Something's wrong.
Hey,
what's
going on here?
Hey, stop! My mouth! No.
Safe. No further questions.
I'm the defendant, a paper processing disposal thingy. Innocent.
Yeah, I won. Well, we won. Here's your fake pay.
Oh, thank you very, very much.
I'll just put it in your slot. H&R, too. Not just because it's your money, but because we're not just a tax thingy anymore. Now, we're a lawyer's service thingy.
Something's wrong.
Well, the other day I went
store.
And I went
shopping, yeah.
And the
shoes.
I shut up.
Get her off me. Get her off of me.
Show you how to open a door.
I don't get it.
What don't you get?
Everything.
What's everything? Do you not get how to open the door?
Yeah.
You turn the knob.
What's the knob?
This. What? Shiny handle-like thing. Mm. And you pull! Get it?
Uh-uh. Which way do you turn it?
Counterclockwise or clockwise? No one really cares.
But where? But if you were in Australia, which way would you turn it?
Counterclockwise? But this is weird.
What about here? What about New York City?
How am I supposed to? I don't care.
Well, you're the door expert, huh?
Clockwise.
Okay. Okay, and so and you turn it, right?
Yeah, you turn it.
How much approximate force would you have to use?
Like, as much as you want.
Pounds per ounce and stuff?
5 million.
Yeah, I think that might break the handle off.
Yeah, that is a little exaggerating. How about, just enough to open it.
How much is that?
You strain your muscles. It's so hard to open. And you ask one more question, I'll tear you limb from limb!
So, you turn the thing and
pull. Yes, that's it. Pull.
And once you pull, how hard do you have to pull?
As hard as it takes to open the door.
And what's the point of opening a door?
So you can get into what's behind the door.
What's behind the door?
That!
So, okay, let me see if I got this. Okay. You turn the thing.
Yes.
Clockwise.
Or counterclockwise. This is a universal door.
Then you pull, and you see what's inside. All I needed to know.
Meow!
I want to try another one. This is real fun. Okay, see, turn and pull. Turn. Oh, wait, I did it clockwise. This must not be a universal door. I mean, counterclockwise. Do it clockwise.
Teacher, I'm not part of the skit anymore. Anymore.
What?
Anymore. He should turn and push when he wants to get out. And in and all that. Turn and pull. Oops.
What would you realize? There's a difference between pulling and pushing.
Something's wrong.
Something is wrong. Terribly wrong. Look at this wrongness.
Well, the other day, I went to the
store?
No! I went to the Happy House. And it had very lovely,
birds?
And it fell down, and broke all over.